Yeah, that's a good fight. because his foot is turning.
My arm! My arm!
Yeah!
Come on, Jen!
We're early now.
All right.
Mark, it looked like we'd come back to get a point at the end there, but a late penalty for Penrith. What were your thoughts on?
It looked like we'd come back to get 3 points because we were in a winning position in the 94th minute, and it's been a drop ball, and we've kicked the ball straight to their goalkeeper, who's standing in the centre of his goal, knowing where the ball was going to go. I mean, you know, in them circumstances to win games, you know, we've got to be ruthless. That ball's got to go and make the keeper run for it and chase for it, and that eats up the seconds we needed, because as we've seen, the penalty was the last kick of the game. So a bit naive from us after fighting so hard to get back in the game, probably the big disappointment.
And the game seemed to turn a bit with the substitution of Ben Harmison. How well do you think he played after he came onto the pitch?
Oh, well, what can you argue with 2 goals? His first one was probably his first or his second touch. But aside to that, he gave us something different because he was winning flick-ons for Lewis to get on the end of and Dean on the other side, and his play on the floor was good, so his impact was massive, which is what you should expect from the bench. Whenever you bring people on, you want them to influence the game, and Homie's been tremendous, yeah.
And another game called off in midweek. It's quite a busy schedule going into the last few weeks. How do you look to the rest of the season and the games remain?
Well, we've just got to deal with it. Some teams are a lot worse off than we are, and my games at the minute are pretty well spread out, so I've got no complaints with our schedule at the moment. I know they've got to fit the Mars game in, which might be a slight complication, but as it stands at the minute, you know, we've just got to go and see, get as many points as we can.
And what is the target for the rest of the season now?
Just said before the game there, we've had 6 games now, so we're kind of coming to the end of the process of assessing, you know, what we've got, trying different things. So now we just want to be a little bit more settled in the running, and pick up as many points as we possibly can and finish as high as we can. It's as simple as that, really.
So a couple of good performances now, you've got a goal to add to it. How do you feel about your start at North Shields?
I'm really, really happy. First couple of games I thought I did well. Against Whitley Bay, that was really, really positive. But then last week away at Bishop Auckland, I think everyone was really, really disappointed, personally myself. I didn't think I'd had a great game, but today, a lot of positives to take, even though we haven't got the win in it, and it might feel like a loss because of the way that we got back into it. But happy to score my first goal, and more happy with the performance from the lads.
And it was a good strike to get the first goal as well. What do you think of the goal itself?
It took a big deflection, mind, but they all count. And I think it was going in anyways, mind. But yeah, just happy to get the account open, and hopefully more will come.
And have you set any targets for the remainder of the season?
Yeah, I said a few weeks ago that I just wanted to chip in with as many goals and assists as I can. Not a target set in stone, but you know, if I'm getting in the right positions and doing the right things and working hard, I think the rewards will come. So yeah, just as many goals and assists as I can for the rest of the season.
And you started on the bench today. How did you feel coming on during the first half? Because that's not a usual thing to happen.
Yeah, I made sure that I was tuned in the first half. You know, sort of looking at the wide positions, looking at the fullbacks, looking at their strengths and weaknesses, so that if I did come on, then I'd be able to make an impact. Unfortunately, Matty came off with a little bit of an injury, but I had to go on and try and make an impact. So I just made sure I was tuned in and focused, so that if the time came, then I was ready. When the red rum goes about.